Oh, hello and welcome to a new video with me, Scott. Today it's gonna be a very interesting video. I'll give you a little look behind the scenes of my videos, how I make my videos, what goes into a video production, and at the end of the video I am going to tell you when I had real fear of death filming one video. So stay tuned, it's gonna be one of the best videos. We start after the intro. Welcome back. I have a little helper here in my pocket because I wrote down the key points. So let's start. Let's start with actually talking about my kayak video adventures, because that's really hard stuff to do. I have to put all my equipment on a little kayak. That means an expensive camera, microphone, tripod, then the drone remote control, so many things, all the food, the water, all the accessories I need for the video. So much goes on the kayak, it's packed full. And then I always go out there on the open sea, and that's kind of dangerous as well, because as you see, there are no boats out there. From time to time there are boats, but far out there, no boats. So if something happens, if I fall off the kayak because of a wave or something, it's really bad, it would be really bad. Or something happens, like the weather changing in minutes, because we have the rain season right now, so alone, that is a dangerous thing to do. And one aspect of my videos, because I'm doing so much videos with kayak adventures. Then the next thing is to give you a little inside look. It's so difficult if you are only one person. It would be so much easier if I have a little film crew, a team, but no. I have to put every camera on my own there, set the focus, set everything, the sound and the scene, and then running back and forth, record, okay, standing there, oh, that shot wasn't good, again. It's so hard to do that alone. Sometimes I even have control the drone with one hand and standing like this, pretending to be, someone else is like controlling the drone, but no, it's all myself, and that's a huge challenge. An example of one special video, because the pirate head video, it's this one here, and alone, like the little treasure map, oh man, that took 3 to 4 hours to do. Together, take my hand and we will conquer the world. This is our final chance. Because I had to draw everything, that's what I did. Then I aged like the map with fire and burning holes, and then ordering here at the restaurant coffee to put the coffee on top to give the treasure map like the aged look of like yellow, brown and all that kind of stuff. And then I had at the restaurant some curry, and I was thinking, oh, that looks like brown, yellowish. So I put some of the curry on top of the map and like did this, and so yeah. It smells like food and coffee now, but looks perfect. But yeah, alone this little treasure map, 3 to 4 hours of work. Love to the detail is very important for me. And in this particular video, you know, that pirate hat, I ordered it on the internet from China. And it took, I think, almost 3 weeks, like 3 weeks until it arrived. So that was also a thing I had to wait for. So that's how it works. And if you are not a YouTuber, you may not know what effort and work goes into the little thumbnail, the thing you click on when you watch a video on YouTube, because that alone takes 2 hours maybe, or just to make the picture, like I'm again running back and forth, setting camera up, oh, it's too late, oh no, I'm not in frame, and again, and again, and again, and I think it's so much work, it takes so much time, and then in post editing, you know, like in Photoshop, contrast everything a little bit more and make it look very nice, putting on the text, that takes hours actually, only the little picture. Then, sometimes, you know, in my videos, you see two characters, Pee-Pee Pete, Some say we are one person, PPP doesn't exist, but that's not true. As you may know, PPP exists, but yeah, no. Honestly, like making all these masks in post-production, the video post-production, and putting in everything that it looks perfect. It's like PPP is really here and it's me on the other side. Takes so much time. Sometimes one video even takes like to record it and to edit it and everything, all the details, like 1 week of work. And at the end, I don't earn any money because my channel is not monetized, so I get zero money for 1 week of work for all my videos. So, you know, I don't make it for the money, I make it because I'm doing it with my heart. I love it, I love doing these videos. Then there is always something not working, always, like a professional production of movies or something like that, they have troubles and problems too. So is it with my videos and productions, because when I went there like for hours on a kayak to that bay, and then I had everything like recorded, and then I wanted to do the drone recordings to finish the day, but yeah, the drone didn't work because my mobile phone got wet and I couldn't connect the mobile phone to the controller on the mobile phone, and yeah, it didn't work. I was like, oh my god, I was so annoyed. And then I actually had to go back there only for the drone recordings for hours. And then that was the moment when I had like fear of death, because out there on the open sea, you go around the island and then that's the open sea, and suddenly the waves started to go up, pick up high, like a difference, 3 meters, maybe 4 meters, and the kayak and me was going up and down, and I could feel my heartbeat. I could feel what was like this, and there was a boat like in the distance, and it disappeared because I was moving up, I saw it, and I'm moving down and the other wave goes up and it disappeared completely, everything. It was like terrifying. And then going into that little channel to the bay, I really was so lucky because minutes later there were big waves and they would hit me like against the rock and everything, and it would be over, really over. I was so lucky. But the thing was, when I arrived, I was trapped there for 7 hours because waves kept coming in high, breaking like really wild. I was like really thinking, my god, I cannot go away now. I was scared, I have to be honest. It was like horrible waiting, and then there was one moment, no waves. I knew I had to be fast, go out, go back, and as you see, I survived. But man, I can tell you, sometimes it was actually really close. So actually, that was it for today and this video. I hope you enjoyed it, so you know now what effort and work goes into my videos. And at the end of my videos, rock the universe. Oh yeah, and write down there in the comments what you think about that. Would you do that for just a few videos and no money? Would that be okay for you? Thanks for watching. See you in the next one, and bye.